topic is thermal expansion. Thermal expansion refers the word that increase in size of object due to heat. So let us understand the concept. Matter is heated. Matter means kya? Solid, liquid or gas. So whatever the matter is heated, matter is made up of tiny particles, that is called molecules. So on heating the matter, there is increase in the internal energy of the particle, or you can say molecule. So molecules and kinetic energy of the molecules increases on heating. What happens in case of solid? In the solid, particles are arranged in a three-dimension regular pattern. That regular pattern is called lattice. So when heat is added to this three-dimensional figure, length, breadth and height in the solid, its shape is fixed. So when heat is added to this three-dimensional figure, what will happen? It will increase lengthwise, it will increase breadthwise, or it will increase heightwise. So all together this lattice structure will seem size. So on heating, what happens? Its particles are very close to each other, so they have no space in between the particles, and their intermolecular force of attraction is very strong. So when it heated, the particles start vibrating vigorously on their mean position. So when they start vibrating at their mean position, force of attraction between the molecules get disturbed and they create some space in between the particles. So due to creation of the space between the particles, the size of the lattice or size of the solid structure increases. This is termed as thermal expansion. Let us try to understand expansion in solid on heating. To understand the concept, I am taking few examples. The first example that I am going to explain is a ring ball experiment. In this experiment, we will need two things, ring and ball. At normal temperature, the metallic spherical ball just passes through the ring. But what happens when the spherical ball is heated? On heating, the size of the spherical ball increases and it does not pass through the ring due to thermal expansion. Explain few more examples. You have must observed there is a gap left between the railway tracks. Two end of the railway tracks, there are gaps are left. Why these gaps are left? So understand the concept. Why these gaps are there? See, the railway track is made up of iron. Iron is metal. So again, metal will expand on heating. So when the train run on the railway track or in the summer, this iron track expand. So to allow the thermal expansion, these gaps are left. So gaps are left in the railway track to allow space for expansion. Next example that I am taking is steel bridge. You have must seen that one end of the steel bridge are kept on roller with some space. Actually, this space is left and is rested on the roller so that in the summer season when the temperature is very high and since it is metal, it is made up of steel, it is metal, so it will expand in the summer season. So this gap will allow expansion in the summer season. If this gap will not left, then what will happen? If beams are fixed on the both side of the pillar, it may cause cracks in the pillar due to expansion and contraction. One more example we can take. You have must seen electrical wire or telephone wire. In the winter season, the wires are tight. The wires are always kept little bit loose because in the winter season, due to contraction, the wire become tight and there is a chance of breakage of the wire. So to avoid such accident, wires are kept little bit loose. In the summer season, the wire sag or wire become loosened due to thermal expansion. One more example we can take to explain the expansion in solid, that is bimetallic strip. Bimetallic strip is used in as thermostat. Thermostat is a device which is used to regulate the temperature in the electrical appliances such as electric iron or electric fire alarm. We are using bimetallic strips. Actually, bimetallic strips work on thermal expansion. Bimetallic strip is made up of two different metals. One metal expand more than other on heating. So suppose this is the diagram of a bimetallic strip. One part of the bimetallic strip is made up of brass and other part is made up of iron. On normal temperature, both rest on each other or parallel to each other. But on heating, what happens? Since brass expand more than iron, so brass will bend towards the iron. So on heating, brass expand more than iron and it will bend towards the iron. More example we can take. When boiling water is poured into a glass tumbler, the glass tumbler may crack. Because when we are pouring the boiled water in the tumbler, the inner wall of the tumbler become hot first. So it will expand first in compared to outer wall. So when boiling water is poured in it, the inner surface of the tumbler being at a high temperature expand more due to unequal expansion between the inner wall and outer wall. It cracks in liquid. Before going into the topic, arrangement of the molecules in the liquid. In liquid, molecules are loosely arranged. That is, you can say that they have little space in between them. And since there is molecular space, particles are loosely packed. So they have less force of attraction between them. The force of attraction is not so strong as solid. So molecules of liquid have restricted movement. They can slide over each other. They can easily separated when they are heated. Because when they are heated, the particles start moving at very high speed and they create more space in between them and they expand more than solid. Different liquid have different rate of expansion for the same degree rise of temperature. As for example, alcohol expand more than water. Water expand more than mercury. Let us understand expansion in liquid. To show expansion in liquid, let us perform one activity. Fill the round bottom flask with a colored water up to brim and fit a capillary tube with one holed rubber cork and pass the narrow tube through the cork and mark the water level in the tube. Suppose the initial level is A. Now place the flask in a water bath and heat the water bath. On heating the water bath, it is observed that the level of the liquid from the tube starts falling and it reaches to level B. This is due to expansion of flask because on heating, flask is affected first, so flask will expand first and provide more space for the liquid, hence the level of the liquid drops. As soon as the liquid in the flask also start getting heat up and it expand and the level of liquid again start rising and it reaches from B to C. So what happens when the liquid in the flask is heated? First, level of the water falls from A to B and then it start rising from B to C. So level of water A to C is called apparent expansion. It is due to expansion of flask, and B to C is real expansion due to expansion in gas. Particles, gas is also made up of molecules, and molecules in the gas are far apart from each other. So they have large intermolecular space in between them. So particles of the molecules are free to move. Due to free movement of molecules, or you can say due to large space in between the molecules, they have least force of attraction between the molecules. So when the gaseous molecule is heated, the kinetic energy of the molecule increases and they start moving up to any place and occupy the complete space available to them. And pressure of the gas increases inside the closed container upon heating. So gas on heating exert pressure on the wall of the closed container. That's why in summer, automobiles' tires get frequently punctured or burst. To avoid such situation, due to expansion of air or on heating, the air inside the tube exert pressure on the wall of the tire, they are advised to fill less air in the tire in summer. Expansion is gas can be studied from this experiment. Take a round bottom flask which is filled with air and closed with a one hole rubber stopper, a narrow capillary tube, a narrow cutted position as shown in the figure, so that one end of the capillary tube is under the water. Now start heating the flask. What will happen? It will be observed that bubbles of the airs are coming out through the capillary tube because air has expanded on heating and it escape from the flask. When we allow the flask to cool, the water rises up in the capillary tube because on cooling, air contract and hence it occupy less space in the flask. The atmospheric pressure on the water surface is greater as compared to the pressure inside the flask. So water start rising up in the capillary tube. This experiment illustrates that air is very sensitive to temperature and it easily expand on heating and contract on cooling.